Hi, I'm Heather Potson, one of the senior systems engineers here at Pessler. Today we're going to talk about the reporting functionality within PRTG. So we're going to do two things. I'm going to show you how to create an out-of-the-box report, and then also we're going to create a brand new report. We'll start by going into the web interface of our PRTG instance. We're going to select Reports, then All. Here you're going to see a list of our out-of-the-box reports. They're the top 100 reports and then a summary report for all sensors. These aren't the actual reports, but they're more templates for the reports itself that you're going to run. Today we're going to use for our first example the summary reports for all sensors. To go into it, we just simply clicked on the words there, the title, and then you see the options that you want to set to run it. First, we can see the period of times you want to run. And you can see you could do your current period, which is today, a previous period, which is yesterday. You could select a period, and you could see a drop-down list of different periods to do, or select a date range manually. I'm going to run previous period yesterday. Then you could choose to view it as an HTML report. You can create and store it as a PDF and data files, or create a PDF and have it sent to you by email. And we're going to view this report as HTML. Select Run Report, and it'll be up in a few minutes. And now you can see here's our HTML report. It's a summary of all sensors for yesterday. Now that that's complete, let's run a brand new report. You go up to Reports and select Add Report. And it's time to start with the basic report settings. You need to give your report a name, so I'm going to call it SLA Uptime. If you want to give it an optional tag, you can. A tag would be used, for example, for quick searching for it later on, just within PRTG. Now it's time to select a template that you would like to do your report on. There's various options, and we're going to go through each of them. The first is a graph with a data table. It will create a report with graphs and data table. Reports in this format can generate CSV or XML files also. You could do a data table only, and you could see your data tables could have various different intervals. Graph only will create a report that is just graphs. List of sensors will create a report in a compact sensor style list. This is available with and without graphs. Top 100, highest and lowest, will create a report with up to 100 objects and the highest and lowest average values. The top 10 uptime downtime will create a report with up to 10 objects with the highest uptime and downtime each. The top 100 uptime downtime is the same except for 100 objects each. I'm going to use the top 10 uptime downtime based on uptime hours. After that, you need to select your security context. That's the user account in which the report will be generated. The report will only be generated and show objects that that user account has access to in PRTG. Next will be time to choose which sensors you're going to add. You can add sensors by tag here, or on the next screen you can add sensors manually. I'm going to use add sensors by tag, and I'm going to put in the ping sensor tag. So this way, any ping sensor will appear in this report. And then we have to figure out what do we want to do with the schedule. If you say no schedule, this report will be available for you to run manually whenever you'd like, or you could choose for it to run automatically. And you could see as you put your different option in here, the processing will change. I'm going to do every day at a specific hour because I want to run at 2 a.m. every day. Sometimes reports can get quite long, so it's best to run them off hours. Then for schedule processing, it's what you want to do with the report. You can save it to disk and send it by email, just save to disk, or just email it. We're going to save this one to disk so I know I can come in every day and take a look at it. What period is this report going to cover? I could choose between the current period, which is today, or previous period, which is yesterday. We'll leave this on previous period. And the report type, do I want to cover it a day, a week, a month, and as you could see, as I change my report period type, the options I have for that will change. We'll do day, and I'm going to keep it on the current 24-hour period selected. If you want to create a report for just certain hours of the day, for instance, if you just want to do business hours, you could change that in this option here. But I'm going to say none because I want everything in a 24-hour period covered here. Now this section talks about including percentiles. PRTG offers percentile calculation in which you can include in your report. The statistical method puts your data in order, for example, from lowest value to highest value, and calculates the percentile you want, optimally informing you about the distribution of your network relevant data. Percentiles are not available for every template. So if you select to put a percentile inside your template and it doesn't have it, then that column will be left blank. If you select to show percentiles option here, the percentile type, the interval average, and the mode will appear for you. The last section that's important to take a look at is for the data files. The template at the top that you chose, if it does include optional data files, you can decide if you want to include them or not, and if you want them in CSV or XML format. Now it's time to hit continue. Remember, I selected my sensors by tag, so you see all of my ping sensors here on the screen. But if I did not select that, or I want to add additional sensors, you could come here and drag and drop any sensors to the left side. If you do that, you can even turn off channels you don't want into your report. So that's a good option if you want to get a very custom report. I'm going to put this one out since it was not in my original report. And then my report's done. It's going to run at 2 o'clock in the morning. But since you're here, I'd like to show you what it looks like. So I'm going to hit run now and do yesterday. And let's just create and store this and run my report. Once the report is done running, we could go into stored reports and it will be there. So let's hit stored reports and I can go in and see my report that I just ran.
If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pestler.com, and always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.